is a slave who longs for the shade.
But if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship.
I have absolutely no interest in watching a game in which I want both teams to lose. Is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. Job must have written those words because the football season was over. Oh, not yet.
The first gift of the Holy Spirit is wisdom.
I emailed my brother Tim after the Super Bowl just to see what he thought, and he responded, he said, I have absolutely no interest in watching a game in which I want both teams to lose. Well, the first reading is a bit of a downer. It's from the book of one of the wisdom books in wrestling with the issue, why do terrible things happen to good people? And we're kind of in the midst of that book. It does end up better than those lines at the end of the book of Job, but you have to read the whole book in order to discover that. Thankfully, the other two scriptures are a bit more upbeat. We hear Paul with a great sense of urgency and compulsion to get the good news out there to people, wanting to be all things to all people. So on fire with the Word of God, that he's just spending his entire life spreading that good news of God drawing near God's people and God bringing the healing, the wholeness that we see demonstrated very dramatically in the gospel. Jesus went around bringing good news to others, setting people free from things that held them back from being their best selves and continuing to inaugurate the reign of God, the kingdom of God among us. So thankfully, Job was not the last word, but it's Jesus who is the last word. That's the living word and the ongoing word. And there are dimensions of the gospel in our current time that are pretty difficult for us to fulfill by ourselves, either individually or even as a local parish. And so a major part of our Catholic faith is coming together in bigger groups of Catholic parishes in order to continue that ministry of Jesus, to bring wholeness, to bring healing, to bring the good news to others. And that's one of the major reasons why we have the bigger structure called the Archdiocese of Milwaukee. And so this is the weekend in all parishes in the Archdiocese where the Archbishop has a couple of words to encourage us to participate in that bigger ministry that we really couldn't do each of us by separate parishes, but coming together collectively that we are able to do through the ministries of the Archdiocese. And we have then a 9-minute message from Archbishop Listecki. Unfortunately, we're not set up in order to be able to show video here in the church, but we can at least hear his words. So here's a chance to kind of use your imagination and picture the Archbishop and picture what he's saying in this 9-minute message to us.
The first gift of the Holy Spirit is wisdom. Pope Francis tells us, wisdom is the grace of being able to see everything, the world and the people around us, with the all-encompassing love of our Creator. To see with God's eyes. Last summer, Catholics from more than 200 parishes, schools, and organizations across the Archdiocese gathered to determine priorities for our church here in southeastern Wisconsin. In each mission area studied, there emerged the desire for all Catholics to know their faith, to be formed in their faith, and to take action. We're called to see with God's eyes, to listen with God's ears, and most importantly, to act so that all will see the face of God through us.
I'm learning to see with God's eyes in that I'm learning to recognize God's presence in everything around us. The seminary has given me the opportunity to grow in love for the person in front of me.
Priests aren't born. They're made, they're formed in the seminary. And that doesn't happen without the commitment of a whole diocese supporting us.
The teaching parish model is set up so that we as seminarians have an encounter with what our life will be like as priests, what our responsibilities will be like when we are priests. The Catholic stewardship appeal is very important to my life as a seminarian and as a future priest because, quite honestly, I don't know that I could be on this path without it.
St. Francis de Sales Seminary is forming more priests than it has in decades. We need priests on fire for the faith to lead us in the sacraments and to continue the spirit of renewal in our church. Last year, we ordained 6 new priests, and today your seminary has 40 outstanding young men enrolled, learning to guide us all to see with God's eyes.
Catholic Charities really looks to look at everyone as an individual, as seeing Christ's face in everyone who contacts us. They're typically in crisis mode, and they're looking to get an answer, and they're looking to get one quick.
He couldn't even sleep at night. He was waking up 5-6 times a night because he's so used to working and the financial strain and the worry of being evicted.
I've been working with Ken and Angela for a couple of months. They called me because they were being evicted.
Good morning, this is Lisa. Can I help you?
They were only a month behind in rent, but they had already been to court.
We seriously had nowhere else to go. We would have had to leave our stuff that we owned, and we would have been sleeping in our car.
They came looking for housing assistance, but then we wrap case management into that as part of our program to help them become stable.
I always worked, you know, 2 or 3 jobs and just met some hard times. So yeah, Lisa from Catholic Charities, she's wonderful.
Last year, Catholic Charities helped more than 27,000 people through employment assistance, pregnancy support, mental health counseling, caring for those with physical challenges, for our seniors, and for those at risk. We know they deserve our love when we see with God's eyes.
Intercultural Ministries is an office of the Archdiocese of Milwaukee. This is part of the mission of the church to reach out to people of all cultures. What happens every Sunday at parishes around the diocese will just totally astound you.
We sing in Lao, we sing in Hmong, we sing in Karen, Karini, English, Spanish, and then there's gospel music too. And I think that just enhances the Mass, and it enhances the community because we get to know one another at the Mass.
Unless everyone is around the table, then we're not truly and fully the image of Christ that we need to be for the world.
When I see reaching out like that, then I feel like I'm welcome. You're welcoming me and you're asking me to come and be a part, and that's what it's about.
The cultural and ethnic diversity in the 10 counties of our archdiocese brings a richness to our Catholic family. By promoting awareness and unity, we strengthen the faith we all share. We position ourselves to embrace everyone's gifts.
In the Archdiocese of Milwaukee, our Catholic school students consistently outperform their counterparts all over the state. Parents don't choose our schools because they are the best academically. They choose them because they're the best academically and they're able to have their child experience their love for God as a part of their schooling.
The future of our church depends on passing the faith to future generations. Catholic schools and Christian formation programs take seriously their mission of forming students in the Catholic faith. Catholic schools are respected for strong academic programs and forming youth in mind, body, and spirit. These ministries form future leaders for service in the church and in our communities. Liturgy is not separate from the rest of our lives. It's the living out of our mission as intentional disciples of Christ. In liturgy, we receive God's gift to us and become God's gift to others, ready to proclaim the good news as we see with God's eyes. Through our synod, we've created a vision and ministerial priorities for the future, a new Pentecost to ignite, renew, and energize us, to help us live like Christ and his disciples, to see with God's eyes. We entrust the fruits of the synod to the Lord and dare to dream how the synod can change life for the better in our beloved Archdiocese. Today, you've seen just a few of the vital ministries that will continue to help us realize our vision. For many of these and other ministries, the only source of support is the Catholic Stewardship Appeal. I invite you to join me in giving as generously as you can. Your gift to the appeal will be used to strengthen Catholic schools and parishes, grow our charitable outreach, and transform the lives of thousands of Catholics. So together, let's choose to act as God's disciples, to see the world with the all-encompassing view of our Creator, and respond in love as we see with God's eyes. Thank you. Bless you all, and know that my prayers are for you always.
So did you catch on to what the theme is? See with God's eyes. Kept repeating it. If you'd like to see the video with your own eyes, you can access it through our parish website, and Andy tells me he's able to connect it with our video of the weekly liturgy on the parish website. It is a well-done video, and it kind of gets the message even more graphic if you're able to watch it that way as well. And this morning we have a guest speaker to help us become more aware of one opportunity we have to see more through the eyes of the Lord. And Sister Lucille has a message to share with us how that might happen for us.
Good morning. I thought Father would say, "And here's Sister." How many of you have heard of an event that is coming a week from tonight, Ignite? How many of you have heard of that or seen it in writing? Not everybody. Okay. So it's a good thing I said I'll come to all the masses and invite, cajole, beg, give you a guilty conscience. So, in your pews are half sheets that I'd like for you to pick up, and these are a gift from me for you to take home and put on your fridge or on the bathroom mirror so you can remember that next Sunday evening we start the spiritual renewal. It's an opportunity that the cluster parishes have prepared for you. Sunday evening, well, we'll go through it here. As I said, As I said, it's a spiritual renewal. It's like a retreat, an opportunity to get your Lent going. How many of you have already started thinking about what am I going to do for Lent? You have company with me. I haven't started yet. But this is an opportunity. So Sunday evening, we will come together to set our spiritual GPS. And we're invited to come with friends and family. We kind of looked at Sunday night as family night. We also wanted to make sure that we had something for those of us who are more seasoned in years and find it difficult to go out at night. And so, on Monday morning, at Good Shepherd, after their Mass, we're going to have an event or a presentation to help navigate the roads that many of us, as we age, we have different kinds of roads. Sometimes they're difficult, sometimes they're problematic. And so that'll be an experience for hope for our older members. Then Monday night, we come back to St. James. By the way, I forgot to mention, we are hosting this retreat. So everything happens here. Monday evening, we come to not discover, but to get in touch with again the fact that I am not alone on this journey. And I'm sure all of us have experienced times in our lives when, I know I have, when I was happy, very relieved in those difficult times that I was not alone. So here we will come to help navigate our moving together, being there, like Paul says in our reading, being there when other people are hurting. And then Tuesday evening is our Mardi Gras. We're going to have a concert and a social. And of course, we have social every night. And we also have child care. But it's important that you call and register your child so we know how many people to prepare, how many children to prepare for. So I invite you. Please come and join us. And I changed my mind, Father. I am going to add two things. Today, we celebrate World Day of Consecrated Life. And you know that the Holy Father has named this year as the year of consecrated life. So I ask that you pray for us who have committed ourselves to this way of life and to the many. And I'm sure there are some sitting here among us, women and men, boys and girls, whom God is calling to serve the church as sisters, as brothers, as priests of religious orders. So that's one PS. The second one is the Holy Father has pronounced today as a day, World Day of Prayer for the end of human trafficking. And you have been seeing that in the bulletin as well. And today is the feast of St. Josephine Baquita, who herself was a trafficked child. And read in the bulletin for an event that we're going to be having also on human trafficking. God bless you.
It's dangerous to give sister a microphone. Thank you, sister. You brought a lot of things together for us to reflect on and to kind of launch us into the coming weeks to ignite our faith and to see with God's eyes. And so we will bring together our various needs and prayers with our prayers of petition as you please stand.